Blood Drive is a vehicular combat game with a variety of chaotic game modes, and it's pretty much a hot mess, but it's a good hot mess. The basic gameplay boils down to three things: how well you smash zombies, how well you smash other cars, and how well you race. There are a variety of weapons and cars to choose from, each with their own nuances. Each car comes with its own unique character that comes with a unique special ability, for example, and all of the weapons are useful for different situations. When you're trying to kill opposing vehicles quickly but don't have a car that's fast enough to catch up and get in close range, for example, the homing drunken missiles will be of use, or if you're just trying to kill zombies incredibly quickly, there's always the minigun, also useful if you are an incredibly fast car and are chasing another slower car right up the butt. Just like the weapons, the cars are all designated to be useful in very specific situations, and you may find yourself fighting an uphill battle if you use a car for an event that it clearly isn't tailored. There's a lot more dynamic chemistry than just the example I'm about to provide, but it is a basic example. You'll obviously find yourself doing a lot better in a demolition event if you have a big, heavy car that can take a lot of hits and smashes into things constantly and is equipped with, say, a railgun. But having such a big, heavy car would be an absolute liability in any of the race events. Finding out which events your car is best at and then excelling in those events is the key to victory. It almost feels like a real sport. Some characters are destined to be better at certain events than others. There's a decent variety in events, and they all seem to be balanced well around the idea that you could choose to play with any of the cars. If this were a straight-up racing or straight-up vehicular combat game, then some of the cars would just be objectively worse than others, but because it's a mix of racing, vehicular combat, and smashing zombies, you can pick any car you want without feeling severely gimped in all events. Sure, you'll struggle with some events more than others, but that's still part of the game balance. Unfortunately, in spite of the game modes and cars being well-balanced for specialization, the game is more concerned with being crazy than it is concerned with being fair. Blood Drive was clearly conceived primarily as a multiplayer experience, and this is most noticeable, of course, in the single player. There are some gameplay nuances designed specifically to be used in multiplayer that don't mesh well at all with the single player game mode. For example, one of the characters, Superstar, has a special ability that allows you to blind other players briefly when you drive by them. A cute idea and a real hindrance in multiplayer, but in single player, the AI just has to pretend they're being blinded, which sometimes they can just choose not to do. The game's maps are very large and also have several shortcuts and secret areas that were clearly meant to be discovered slowly by the player base as they played games with each other, and used those shortcuts to get an upper hand on one another. So it can feel a little unfair to be completely annihilated by the AI, which has every bump on the map completely ingrained into its robot consciousness, thus ensuring that you lose almost every checkpoint rally on your first try. Lastly, there are the intentionally exaggerated, ridiculous physics, which may get good laughs and have a lot of chaotic fun behind them in multiplayer, but in single player, when you're trying to actually win, the physics getting you stuck in places isn't so much fun anymore. Thankfully, this only happened twice to me, but I could see it happening a lot more to other people. There are some other complaints, such as the game outstaying its welcome. It takes around 16 hours roughly to unlock every ending for every character, which is a massive time investment for a game this repetitive, which should at most be around 8 hours. But don't let those admittedly valid criticisms deter you from playing the game or convince you that it's a game of chance. Playing stupidly will always end with your loss, and playing smart will usually get you the victory. Usually. All in all, as a driving game about being stupidly bombastic, Blood Drive avoids the pitfall of being entirely luck-based mayhem and manages to inject absurd amounts of personality into an otherwise slightly above average game experience. This is the kind of incredibly ridiculous game that justifies the existence of middleware titles. Wait, this shit was published by Activision?